Welcome to Reality Creator Radio. Reality Creator Video. I'm Hermes. And I just got finished cooking that beautiful batch of ruby red that you get right over there. That is colloidal gold. I call it absolute colloidal gold because I like naming my colloidal golds, as you found out in the last video. Now, believe it or not, I got some questions from the last video already. So I'm going to answer a couple of these, and I figured the ruby red is, like, it's so dramatic when you're cooking the ruby red. And I shot time-lapse video of making the ruby red, and I'm going to put that in this video when I get to post-processing. So you can see how the solution goes from perfectly clear distilled water to this beautiful dark red color. And it really is a magnificent color red. And ruby red, colloidal gold, like I said in the last video, has a lot of health benefits. You can look a lot of them up on the internet. My main reason for using it for myself, well, besides the fact of increased mental clarity, the inflammation in my sinuses going away for the first time in 10 years or 15 years, however long it's been that I've had them, and increased energy, and just getting things done throughout the house and the yard, and like these videos, something in the gold stimulates the mental processes in your brain. And the people that I've shared the gold with have given me telling me the same thing. In fact, one of the things they first tell me when they're on colloidal gold is they say, for some reason, I got things done that I haven't gotten, that I've wanted to do, but I haven't gotten done in a really long time. And this was a very common thread. It took about 4 days on the colloidal gold for them to start feeling that way. It didn't happen immediately. Colloidal gold has to build in your system, you know. But once it does, I mean, it just fires away. So, like I said in the last video with gold, the colloidal gold is like the cream of the crop, but of colloidals. But they all do something significant, you know. And there's lots of different colloidals. I'm only dealing with 4 colloidals right now, but I plan on adding a few more colloidals down the road as I invest in equipment and things like better other equipment and stuff. So, as you guys can tell, I prefer the clinical or laboratory approach to colloidal, making my colloidals. There are lots of people on the internet, you can do internet search, who just, they cook it in their kitchen, they cook it in their backyard, the colloidals. That's fine too, you can do it that way also. I like to be pretty precise about my colloidals, and I like laboratory quality colloidals. Now, I'm not saying theirs aren't laboratory quality colloidals, but I've got this down with science, an art form. I mean, this ruby red cooked, this is 550 milliliters of ruby red. I cooked that in 30 minutes. And believe me, to get it perfect like that in 30 minutes, it's not an easy thing to do because there's all these little variables with the cooking the colloidal gold that have to go into it. To get it to do that, I mean, the first batch of colloidal gold I cooked, and I'll put a picture in there, was purple. Had no idea why purple came out. It's supposed to be this color. I got purple. And, oh, man, it was, what a, I had the, read the ingredients wrong and the formula wrong. I brought in a chemist, and it took a while to actually get the formula correct for colloidal gold, so that every time I get that when I cook it in 30 minutes. So that colloidal gold is not easy, and it's not a colloidal that I would suggest you start with. I would suggest you start with colloidal silver, which is the easiest thing to do. But I'm not really talking about colloidal silver in this video. We're going to talk about all the colloidals that I work on in videos as they come along. So Anyway, okay, I have some questions already, so let's go to the question. One of the questions is, what is exactly happening with the metal and the colloidals and things like that? And that's an interest. That's a good question. But what is exactly happening here? All right, this is my gold rod. Okay, I get to see that. All right. In the last video, you saw the zinc rod. Now, this gold rod, gold is not cheap. All right, so this thing is made up of three or four, it's like three and a half-ish, 22-gauge gold wires twisted together. The thing is, the more gold you have in the solution, the faster it cooks. I started with my first colloidal gold thing was with one piece of 22-gauge colloidal gold wire. Thick piece of gold, like together like this, I can cook it in 30 minutes. So, anyway, what happens here is the reaction from the electricity being applied to the gold and the other electrode here is copper. In the case of gold, we use a copper anode. All that does is put the electricity into the water, and you get a current flow from the copper to this one. And then with the addition of a few household chemicals, in order to, because gold is a little stingy, if you were going to cook gold without any chemicals, like I cooked the zinc, took 5 hours to cook. You're going to cook gold without any kind of magical chemicals in there, it take 8 days. Sorry, that's a little bit too long. And I am not even sure of the quality that you would get after 8 days. Not to mention what would happen to the gold itself. Now, so the process we have now puts as little stress as possible on the gold that you're using, because that's the expensive part of the whole process with colloidal gold. And gold comes off of here, all right? It goes into a nanoparticle state, okay? Little pieces of gold are removed from the gold rod and go into the liquid, and they want to reach this anode over here, which is on the other side, because physics wants it to attach itself to that anode that's over there. So now we have a few extra chemicals in here to make it harder for this gold to get here and attach itself to there. So what happens is, in the process of it traveling around, you'll notice it's spinning. Okay, I always spin the liquid, and the reason you spin the liquid is you don't want the gold or whatever it is that you're making. You don't want it to go from here to here and attach itself there. It never makes it into the liquid. So you want to do everything possible to make it hard for that gold or whatever metal it is that comes off of here. You want it to go into the liquid. You don't want it to go into here. So what happens after a few seconds, a few seconds, it could be microseconds, I don't know how fast it is. If it's not attached to that gold rod, it gets frozen in the liquid. And you have a tiny piece of whatever the metal is floating in the liquid. That was the laser beam trick. You know, I showed you the laser beam. This is the laser beam for... I don't know if you really can't see it because of the ruby red and the red laser beam. Anyway, when you shoot the laser beam in here, you are lighting up all the tiny little metal particles that are floating in the water. They're not really dissolved. I think in the last video I mentioned the word dissolved at one point. I mentioned the word suspended, but then later on in the video I said they were dissolved in the water. And that's really not true. They're not dissolved in the water. These metals are suspended in the water. They're trapped in a virtual state of being trapped in the liquid. So when you consume a colloidal, it goes into your body, it's suspended in the liquid, and then it's deposited in your body, and your body then chews on it or eats, you know, new nutrients from these little tiny pieces of nanoparticle metal. Colloidals are actually considered, this process is actually considered nanotechnology. And you know what? I'm going to have a video on the nanotechnology part of this. I'm not going to do it in this one because we're going long enough as it is. But there's amazing stuff going on a nano level when you cook this stuff that science doesn't even know about it. I mean, I know about it. These colloidals are the beginning of, like, nano machines. I'm telling you. But not nano machines like from sci-fi. We're talking about nano consciousness, tiny pieces of consciousness. I'm going to talk more about that later. I'm going to whet your appetite. So you're going to keep coming back and saying, well, when is he going to do that video on that? I want to get to more questions. So we talked about the suspension, how the colloidals are suspended in the liquid. Now the reason, okay, some of the colloidals have color and some of them don't, which is what I got here. Whoa, what do I want to show you? Oh, shoot, I put it away. Well, let me show you here. Okay, this, no, that's, oh, here it is. Yes, okay, got to find out where my stock is. Okay, this is colloidal copper. You'll notice it's a light blue, cyan color. Okay, and this is the colloidal zinc from yesterday. I filled him up. He's clear. Okay, and this is colloidal silver. I call this gargle blaster. Now, colloidal silver is normally clear, but you can overcook it to a yellow color. And this particular colloidal silver is just a tiny bit of colloidal yellow and colloidal clear. I'll talk about that when we talk about colloidal. Watch the glass. Maybe I'll edit that out. Maybe not. I'll talk about that when we get to colloidal silver. All right. We did zinc in the last show, doing gold in this show, plus some questions. So when we get to colloidal silver, I'll talk about the two different kinds of colloidal copper and the two different kinds of, well, actually there's three different kinds of colloidal copper and the two different kinds of colloidal silver that I use. I am Hermes, and this is Reality Creative Video, and I will talk to you again soon. Bye.